Motor Cars. It is July 21st, heading towards the latter part of the summer. Birthdays this weekend. On the 21st, we have Anthony Benseveni, who is the car wash manager over here on this side of town. Anniversaries this weekend. On the 22nd, we have Dylan Bell, who is at the Brunswick Car Wash. And on the 23rd, John McCumber, who is in the Honda Moto team. So happy birthday and happy anniversaries, guys. I would like to talk a little bit about this weekend, the culture of no. The culture of no comes into play when we explain to a customer very politely, of course, why we can't help them. When we tell a customer that we can't schedule them for a particular service because they don't know their VIN number and the service application won't allow us to schedule a particular service without it. Or when we tell a customer that we can't throw in floor mats because we're already selling the vehicle for less than it cost us. Or when we tell a customer that sometimes detail services do come back dirtier than they go in. When we tell a customer that we couldn't reproduce an issue because it only happens above 60 miles per hour and there isn't anywhere nearby that we can road test at that speed. Or when we tell the customer that even though they have a service coupon for a service shop that's not a dealership, we won't take that coupon. When a customer calls to say that their temp tags expire tomorrow and there's nothing that we can do about it. When a customer asks if we text coupons or repair status or monthly incentives, and on and on. We're almost always polite when we tell a customer no. We speak in calm, measured tones, and we always have a sympathetic look on our faces, and sometimes we even have thrown a shrug that says, "What are you gonna do?" You know what? Customers don't give a damn why we can't do something. All they see is that we're an obstacle to getting what they want or need. And what do you do with an obstacle? You go around it. If they have more aggressive personalities, they might ask to talk to your manager. If they think that you aren't really listening, or if you're the second or third person that they've told their story to, they might even ask to talk to Matt or Trevor or Chuck. Most people don't have that kind of personality, though. Most people just hang up. Then they go someplace else. Forever. And they tell everyone on Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, and on to do the same. The culture of no is a trap. For a business, it's a fatal trap. There's only one way out. Find a way to say yes. The culture of yes takes more work. You have to offer alternatives. Would you prefer this or this? Or teach yourself to say, "We may not be able to do that, but we might be able to do this. Does this work for you?" The culture of yes takes creativity and some flexibility, which is a good thing because an inflexible person is often a corpse, and an inflexible business is almost always one. Have a good weekend, Motor Cars.